Hello friends, in this video I will let you know about the physiology of pain. The pain is an unpleasant sensory and emotional experience associated with actual or potential tissue damage, described in the terms of such damage. This is defined by the International Association for the Study of Pain for scientific and clinical purposes. When the tissue gets damaged, some chemicals are released. These are bradykinin, prostaglandin from the cell membrane, potassium ions, interleukin first, and tumor necrosis factors, etc. The platelet also secretes the serotonin. The pain receptor in the skin and other tissues are all our free endings. These are called nociceptors. Stimulated free nerve endings releases two chemicals, calcitonin gene-related peptide and substance P. These substances stimulate the mast cell to release histamine and nerve growth factors. These chemicals stimulate the free nerve endings. The substance P causes the plasma extravasation, and the calcitonin gene-related peptide causes the dilatation of blood vessels. As a consequence, the edema occurs. The edema further causes the release of bradykinin. Again, it stimulates the nociceptors. These free nerve endings uses two separate pathways for transmitting the pain signals into the central nervous system. Mechanical and thermal sensations are carried out by the fast, sharp pain pathway. The chemical signals are carried out via slow, chronic pain pathway. This pathway contains thinly myelinated A-delta fibers and this pathway contains unmyelinated C-fibers. The speed of conduction is 6 to 30 meter per second in these fibers and 0.5 to 2 meter per second in these fibers. The neurotransmitter glutamate is released from these fibers, which has duration of action few milliseconds. These fibers releases the substance P and the glutamate, which have the duration of action of milliseconds to minutes. On entering the spinal cord, the pain signals take two pathways to the brain: the neospinothalamic tract for fast pain, the paleospinothalamic tract for slow chronic pain. The fast type A delta pain fiber terminates mainly in lamina first, which is called lamina marginalis of the dorsal horn. In this pathway, the peripheral fibers terminates in the spinal cord almost entirely in the lamina second and third of the dorsal horn, which together call substantia gelatinosa. Most of the signals then passes through one or more additional short fiber neurons within the dorsal horn themselves before entering mainly lamina 5. Here, the last neuron in the series gives rise to long axon that passes first through the anterior commissure to opposite side of the cord, then upward to the brain in the anterior lateral pathway. The slow and fast fibers enters into the brain stem via the anterior lateral pathway. A few fibers of the neurospinothalamic tract terminates in the reticular area of the brainstem, but most pass all the way to the thalamus without interruption, terminating in the ventrobasal complex and posterior nuclear group of the thalamus. From these thalamic areas, the signals are transmitted to other basal areas of the brain. And to the somatosensory cortex, like somatosensory area 1st as well as somatosensory area 2. So dear friends, this is all about the pain pathway. For more updates, kindly subscribe my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching and stay tuned.